Good morning, Dominic.
Morning, Frank.
How are you?
I'm fine.
So, what are we doing today?
I have a surprise for you.
I'm going crazy with excitement here. Where exactly are we driving to now?
We're driving to Minden, where we're going to look at a platform. And the unusual thing about it is that it's mounted not on a truck, but on a bridge inspection vessel.
Yes, I've heard of that. That sounds really interesting. So I'm very excited to see what that will look like.
When we received this inquiry, it was totally uncharted territory for us. And yes, we had to do a lot of rethinking. But you'll see just how successful the end product is. We're about to meet Frank Asche. He's the captain of the vessel, and he's going to show us exactly what he uses the vessel for. We'll also have the opportunity to join him on an operation.
Super. So we're going to be sailors. It's going to be an exciting day, I think.
Yes, I can't wait. Hi, Frank.
Hi, greetings. Come on over. Hi, welcome. Let's hope we can fit everything in today. The vessel was built back in 1969, and there's been an access platform on here ever since. So here you can see this beautiful piece of PALFINGER machinery. We've had this one on here since 2019, and so far it's still great. A fantastic piece of equipment.
So you mean this special stabilizer is tailored specifically to this vessel, to this job? I mean, the four supports you can see here.
Exactly. We only need these supports mainly when we're in the middle of the canal. We don't really need them for general stability. We wouldn't keel over without them.
So this is your vessel. Of course, I know it doesn't actually belong to you.
The vessel belongs to the Federal Waterways and Shipping Administration.
But are you married, so to speak, to the vessel?
Exactly. I'm the skipper here. My colleague is the second in command. There always have to be two people on board.
Okay, so what are we going to be doing today?
We'll be setting off for the bridge soon. We'll also meet an engineer. Let's see what we can manage with you today.
That sounds really exciting.
So the main thing is that you don't get seasick today, otherwise...
So when I look at this here, I reckon this must be a pretty cool job, wouldn't you say? What makes the job so special? I mean, it must be a great feeling floating across the water here.
Yes, this really is the best job for me. I couldn't imagine doing anything else. But you have to be born to do this. I spent my whole life on boats. My parents had a boat. No sooner had I left the hospital than I was on a boat.
So now you have here an aerial work platform with a maximum working height of 35 meters.
Yes.
When I look at the bridges here, I can see they're just 5, 6, 7, 8 meters high.
Yes, and as you can see ahead, there are some large arches. That's why it's so nice to have these 35 meters so that we can reach everything.
And does the performance of the equipment and also its lateral outreach help you to save time? Simply because you have a bigger working area?
Definitely, when you look at some of this here. This is the barrage gate, not this one. But look at the arch bridge there, for example. We used to have to make 6 settings there. But nowadays, we can do everything with just 4.
So, Frank, since we're talking about working with the platform on the vessel, what does a typical day look like for you?
My colleague and I get on the vessel in the morning. We make ourselves a coffee, of course, and do some preparations. And then, of course, we first check the access platform to make sure that everything is okay. And then we set off for the bridge, as we're doing now. Then we meet our engineer, and we get to work. We do whatever the engineer needs and sail wherever they need to go. We'll be right back.
So, let's talk about the platform. How is the platform secured to the vessel? What challenges did you have to deal with?
Connecting the platform? Well, that was a whole new challenge. The old access platform had a completely different design. We had to reinforce the deck. We had to add a new floor. And we had to build a new shaft. Those were some pretty tough shipbuilding challenges.
And what about the process of securing the platform to the vessel, so from PALFINGER's side?
The main difference is that we normally mount platforms on trucks, and the setup there is pretty clear, so we know exactly where to position the components. The main challenge here is that the equipment, all the electrical boxes, hydraulic boxes, and the engine pump unit, need to be accommodated below deck, and there's much less space available there than on a truck.
So, Dominic, this is the solution we have now. What next? This is certainly a highly customer-specific solution. How do we deal with it in the future?
I think that the key to success was that we were able to use components and systems from our standard portfolio and achieved a truly customized specialty solution with just a low level of customization. And I think that's an important building block for the future.
Many thanks. This was a fantastic experience. We gained some fantastic insights into your job, what you do with the platform, what your daily routine is. So this was a really great experience for us. Many thanks. It was brilliant.
So all I'll say is get home safely.
Yes, thanks.
So, Frank, did I promise you too much?
Definitely not. It was a great day, wonderful experience, a wonderful solution, and difficult to top, I'd say. Let's go to the Unimog, and I'll show you another solution. And yes, I really want you to see it.
I'm looking forward to it.